Hello guys, welcome to another series of 2JZ Tuesday. My name is Michael Chung, and today I'm going to share with you guys about how to select an aftermarket ECU for your engine. First thing is, you need to decide what kind of engine you are using. Okay, how many number of cylinders that you are using. You are using 4 or 6 or 8 or 10 or even 16, okay? This one is, you have to decide at first before you select your aftermarket ECU, right? So, let me explain why it is important is because some of the, we call it a lower grade ECU, they can manage up to 4 individual ignition and 4 individual injectors. Okay, so if you are going for 6 cylinders or 8 cylinders, the same ECU may not be able to support that, or you might want to go for the second one, which is you're going for waste spark configuration. That means you are firing both spark plugs at the same time. Okay, so for example, if you are using a 6-cylinder engine, but you are using an ECU which can support up to 4 cylinders only, so you need to use a waste spark configuration. That means both spark plugs are firing at the same time. Okay, so you'll be just using 3 outputs from the ECU. Alright, so the second one, what's your preference? Okay, if you prefer to ignite the spark plugs sequentially, okay, so you may want to go for a higher level of ECU because they have multiple outputs that can fire the spark plugs individually. Alright, so what's the advantages of going for sequential rather than a waste spark is sequential, you have lesser duty cycle, that means lesser sparks going on for the, you have longer spark plugs life and also longer ignition coil or even igniter's life. Alright, if your ECU can support without igniter, you can just save your money. But if your ECU requires an external igniter, then you have to buy for it. Alright, okay, the third thing is you need to not only roughly, you have to detail out your planning. Alright, your auxiliary outputs, okay, how many outputs you want to go for the fuel pump or aircon, and for all the different engine light, shack light, everything, you have to list down everything first so that you know exactly how many outputs, and you can expect more from the ECU. Okay, for example, you might calculate that you may just need 5 auxiliary output, so you can go for those ECU with 5 or more auxiliary outputs, so when you need more, there are more outputs for you. Alright, okay, input. Okay, this one is quite fun, is because there are two things. One is based on the tuner. If the tuner wants to see everything from his computer, then you may need a lot of input. Alright, or the driver. If the driver wants to see all the inputs from the computer or from his dash, then you may want to have a lot of input. Examples of input, for example, important ones, okay, like water temp, oil pressure, fuel pressure, okay, boost levels, okay. So for more higher levels, you may want exhaust gas temperature and auto sensor and turbo speed and like maybe flex fuel sensor. Alright, all these kind of things are quite crucial, especially you are going for a higher level of engine tuning. For example, you want to go for a CAN bus capability, then you may need a higher level or later version of the ECU. Alright, they can support CAN bus, and especially for people who wants to go for those dash loggers, okay? And maybe your ECU, or maybe you want to have a drive-by-wire, especially when you want to go for drive-by-wire to control your anti-lag or your idle control and everything like that. Alright? Okay, so the number four. The number four is the support availability. Alright? Depends on your local tuner also, or maybe recently it is quite becoming more and more popular, which is the tuner can tune your engine remotely. That means the tuner is not present in that place, in the dyno, but he can tune for you. But of course, he may need some help to visually check all the parameters and all the calibrations has done. Then he can do the tuning. Okay, so depends on the availability of your tuner and the manufacturer's support. Okay, some support are provided in terms of the manual, or the software can refer to you to another website for more information, or the better, which is to provide more videos for you guys to explain what are the each of the functions and all the things that you can play with. Okay, so some manufacturers such as EMU, ECU Masters, they are quite new, but they are providing very good ECU, very high tech with low price, but their video support is not as good as others. Okay, for example, Adaptronic, their video support are really, really good. Okay, especially Andy, I want to give a thumbs up for him, because he's a very, very good tuner and he creates amazing products and able to show a lot of videos for us to learn. Okay, these kind of things are very important, so that for us DIY tuner or a normal engine builder, we need to know all these kind of things, so that when we do our engine, we have to plan for them too. Alright? Okay, so the fifth one is the cost. Okay, I list this one, the cost, as the least important. Okay, because sometimes when we spend money for the engine building, we may be spending like, just shut up and take my money, right? But actually, we need to take this one into account, especially this rabbit hole, it can be go how deep, depends on you. Okay, the cost of the ECU is not as important as the supporting parts. Okay, the supporting parts, for example, like if you are going sequential, you might need to have a lot of ignition coils. Maybe you might need different igniter also. Okay, and sensors. Okay, sensors, like just now I said a little bit, the EGT, the turbo speed, okay, the boost, the auto sensor, accelerometer, especially when you guys are going for drag. Okay, some drags, they might need to use accelerometer, but normally they use GPS and the wheel speed sensor or the drag shaft speed sensor. Alright, temperatures, all the oil or the water temp, maybe even the intercooler in and out temp, so that to measure the efficiency of the intercooler pressures, water, oil pressures. Okay, so all the sensors which can add up into a very big amount. Alright, and actuators, for example, if you have a boost solenoid, boost actuator, different engine fans to operate at different temperatures, or even a fuel cooler. Okay, so all these kind of things that you have to take into account, because all these small things can end up become very, very huge amount. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoy this video, and please comment below if you guys got any question about selecting an ECU. I'm not supported by the ECU that I've mentioned previously, but those are the ECU that I found very interesting and easy to learn. Please share this video if you guys think that this video can help your fellow in terms of engine building and selecting an ECU. And subscribe for more videos, so that you guys can know when I upload my most recent one. See you! Okay guys, press the like button if you guys like this video, and share with your friends if you think this video will benefit them.
subscribe for more videos, and I'll share more insights of 2JZ engine building. See you!